One of the important features of storytelling is that often at some key point in the narrative, the audience members move from being listeners to a story about someone else, and they suddenly find themselves in the story. I believe this story, particularly in the second half, takes on that characteristic. So let's just take a quick look at it. Jesus comes to a house, and again, such a crowd comes around him, but they weren't even able to eat bread. And when his family heard it, they came out to seize him, because they were saying, oh, he's out of his mind. And the legal experts who came down from Jerusalem were saying, no, he's possessed by Beelzebul. He drives out demons by the ruler of the demons. And summoning them, Jesus began to speak to them in riddles, saying, how is Satan able to drive out Satan? If a house is divided against itself, that house can't stand. And if a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom can't stand. And if Satan really did rise up and is divided and against himself, he can't stand, but he's already at an end. And surely, no one's able to enter into the house of the strong one and plunder his goods unless first he bind the strong one. Well, then he could plunder his house. And he said to them, I tell you, this is the way it is. Everything will be pardoned humanity, their sins and whatever blasphemies they blaspheme. But those won't ever receive a pardon, but they're guilty of a sin to eternity. Blaspheme against the Holy Spirit. See, because they've been saying to him, he has an unclean spirit. His mother and his brothers come, and standing outside, they sent someone to him. And a crowd was sitting around him, and they say to him, Jesus, your mother and your brothers are outside seeking you. And answering them, he says, well, where are my mother and my brothers? And looking at those seated around him, he says, here are my mother and my brothers. Because everyone who does the will of God, they are my mother and sister and brother. The Gospel of our Lord. So again, note that it begins as a story about what happened to Jesus, but throughout it and suddenly within it, the audience, and I think this translates better live than it does in a video, but I think you can imagine this. The audience suddenly becomes the people seated around Jesus. That direct relation, that the story is appealing to them, that the story is commending them for following God's will, and therefore being siblings and like a mother to Jesus, that is facilitated by the use of historic presence. That is, throughout this text, it says, and he said, they say. And that kind of collapses the time between then and now. I also want to note that there's clearly a conflict between Jesus and his household. First, they think he's crazy. Sympathetically, I think they're worried about the man. And the legal experts who are also concerned about their people, and I think have a legitimate concern that who is this guy and why is he doing what they think they do. So I try to voice both concerns in a way that we understand they have real concerns and they're not simply hypocritical or out to pursue him. But notice that Jesus challenges them about what happens first with his household, with the house divided. Second, with a nation, when a kingdom is divided against itself, that it'll lead to its destruction. they are the issue he has, particularly with the legal experts, is not simply that they're attacking him, but the Holy Spirit is being manifested, and they think that that is actually an evil spirit, an unclean spirit. I hope you enjoy telling this story. Thank you.